Yes, over here, we've got a lot of yaupon. The yaupon are invasive. When they catch fire, they light up like a firecracker.
It's another Neighbors Helping Neighbors workday for the members of the Alum Creek Wildlife Management Association.
Ta-da, just like that.
Every couple of months, these Bastrop County residents get together to do conservation and habitat work on the property of another Alum Creek landowner.
Now that pine tree has some breathing room. Didn't even know it was here.
The pine forests around Bastrop County are ideal habitat for the Houston toad. Listed as an endangered species in 1970, these toads are currently on the brink of extinction. When the Alum Creek Wildlife Management Association first got started in 2008, its one and only goal was improving and increasing habitat for the Houston toad.
That is not the norm. The norm is landowners working together to improve habitat for white-tailed deer or turkey or quail. I have never seen another wildlife management association that formed to improve habitat for a federally endangered species like the Houston toad.
One of the ways Alum Creek members help improve habitat for the Houston toad is with brush control. Thinning yaupon and cedar opens up the understory, which leads to more plants on the ground, which in turn attracts the insects that the toads feed on. The members of Alum Creek own relatively small parcels of land. There are 132 properties in the group. The smallest is just 1 acre, the largest 880. Altogether, the association covers over 5,000 acres.
What they do on their individual properties collectively adds up to the impact that somebody that controlled all of that acreage as a single landowner would do, no matter how small their property is.
Pomegranates are real hardy here. It's got a bud.
When Judy Edwards bought her property in 1991, she could hear Houston toads calling from a nearby pond. 2 fires and 1 hurricane later, a lot has changed.
It's been 7 years, and I'm still stumbling over black stumps. That doesn't seem fair. So I had flooding, I had erosion, I still have issues with that. I realized how much good the trees were doing by stabilizing my soil.
And then these are gabions, and I had a work day here.
Yeah, Neighbors Helping Neighbors.
Right, right.
The Alum Creek members have volunteered for several work days at Judy's place, removing debris, building erosion controls, and planting trees.
It's more of a collective goal, and it's amazing how much 10 or 12 people can get done in one morning.
Looks good to me.
These are 2.5-year-old seedlings that we planted. We'll have a forest here before long.
Matt and P.J. Hilburn's property was not directly affected by the wildfires of 2011 and 2015, but the association's latest goal is one that they've fully embraced.
What could they do to protect their properties from suffering the similar loss that their neighbors did during the fire?
The road's right there, so we left a privacy hedge, and it's only like 6 foot thick and 6 foot high.
It's more than 6 foot high.
Well, it's grown a couple of foot since we trimmed it up.
Matt and PJ's 10 acres are mostly loblolly pines, but when they purchased the land, it was thick with yaupon and cedar. The yaupon is an oily plant that, left unchecked, creates a massive fire hazard.
And that's what we were wanting to do, is to get that out of the way to have fire mitigation, but also give the grasses a chance to grow. So you had the toad habitat a little bit better if they come back over here and then replant all the loblolly pines.
The blue stems have come back and the little seedlings are starting to come back. It's beautiful.
This one looks pretty scrawny for its height.
As the Alum Creek Wildlife Management Association continues to grow, the members will keep working on behalf of the endangered Houston toad. They'll continue to help restore the fragile lost pine forest. And most of all, they'll be there for each other, like good neighbors.
Okay, go to work.